Irawe si gba mi je mori gwa ra woro.
Oh, yeah. Story in where kingdom is another statement. This is a great privilege. We promise to testify with our sense of responsibility. Wereji Town is the ancestral homeland of Wereji people, alias Abome, Abobo Kirikiri, and Okandobo Eri. Our ancestral father, led by Olilero and Kokolo, migrated from Ife to Uke, and later moved to Uko in the present day Ondo State. Wereji people got to the area of their present settlement at about the 12th century. The first settlement of Wereji people was at Tebu, from where they moved to Wereji Sisi, former Wereji, with two of their siblings. In Wereji South and Wereji Southwest, local government area respectively. They returned to the water through Arontonlero in today's Tebu, having discovered unsavory spiritual misconduct by his kings, and later went to found Tebu Manor in the present day Ogun State. Of Kokolo and Olero respectively finally moved from Rekisi to Akoleko due to some spiritual misfortune, while still keeping touch with the former as their farmland and spiritual homeland. Akoleko is a not distant place from this present settlement of the town. Olero begat Jago, who begat Okiri, Edulisen, and Omama Nemo and Anne. Anne, female, got married to Wereji at first and gave birth to her only child called Erefoluwa. Kokolo begat Esinoro, who begat Dero, and Dero begat Adbelekon and other siblings. History has it that Ginoa the first made contact with Wereji people in the 14th century. Then the god of the sea, Omalokun, was sent for him on request, after which he was offered a wife named Irawoli. The daughter of Esinoro gave birth to the general, two sons of Inua the first. The god of the sea for Inua the first, Wereji people, and made their kings from Bodo and Omadino, who equally partook in the officiating ceremony, that the resolution and spiritual pronouncement as the king that reigns over the river and kingdom came into existence. The salutation so is associated with the salutation of the sea goddess Omalokun by Wereji people and Olajuwon of Ikorodu when sending their gods of the sea. The cultural and traditional arts of Wereji people. Wereji people were known to have migrated with great civilization from Ile Ife, Yoruba people, Olajuwon to Sekin, over the kingdom. For these great tribes and language and culture, we have been able to sustain this pristine culture and language as an identity in our songs, dancing, and communication, spoken words, things. So the culture we have maintained from generation to generation. Coconut and palm fruit farming is a culture imbibed by Wereji people from their Yoruba origin, as evident in the great Gochokun farmland. Culturally, we are known with the art of using the stink ring. Scientific name is Mantra Refish. In his secret is called Opoto. As a canoe to convey our people into the sea for spiritual liberation, cleansing and worship to the gods of the sea in Omalokun. The connection of Wereji to this thing, Refish, emanated from Olero, one of our founding fathers, whose mother, Ladoku, is a marine being who sent the stink ray when conjured in spiritual incantation by Olero and siblings. Another notable artifact of Wereji people is the magical whip in Ishekiri is called Etoni, with which they discern and navigate the positive direction to take during the years of migration. The power of this magical whip also belongs to Deran Kokolo, and this becomes part of Wereji community logo and insignia from time immemorial. Other historical artifacts worthy of note in Wereji are the Iroko trees, planted to mark the reign of every king in Wereji Kingdom, from beginning from Ginoa the first. This is planted after the gods of the sea has been served praying for peaceful and successful reign and longevity of the reigning king at Kechukwu. There was a break in this practice during the reign of Tenkuma Eyolusan as a result of the skirmishes between Princess Iye and siblings against Crown Prince Orefoluwa, who later returned to settle in Kechukwu in 1795.
Were the family ties with Omadino and Ogbodo communities. It is right that there are 5 Aboriginal communities in Were Kingdom. 3 out of these have shared common origin and migration history. Oredu, Omadino and Ogbodo migrated together from Ife to represent the Were Kingdom. This is evident in their spiritual lives, though with some degree of differences. There are some common deities which cut across these communities.
Worthy of
mention. While Redu, as we say, Olemolesin, Alabija, the Bill Malegare, Mim.
History has it that they shared these deities at the point of their separation to form their various different kingdoms of communities. Redu community land.
We to share boundaries with the Eguro and the Northern Axis, Abiborodo and the Eastern Flank between Utupaya and the Benue River and the Western Axis. The southern part is bounded by the Uluri Creek. Bresi B Market is part of Kechukwu land of the Redu community. The present settlement of Redu Town is an highland with a total area of 6,895.0 hectares. Redu community shared boundary with the two states in Abianukon at the western flank, or Bontelaida Dudu Town at the southern as through Lagos Junction, Benin River at the eastern fair, and Koko at the northern hemisphere. No doubt, from the life size of Redu land, it could be taken for granted that there will always be conflict with neighbors and settlers on our land. Over the years, we have been grasping with this challenge to the best of our ability and resources available. Edo State has been a pain on our neck on several occasions, erroneously claiming Redu community as part of the state. But we have consistently resisted this claim and maintaining our loyalty to the Were Kingdom and Delta State government, where we naturally and historically belong. Similar pressure came up recently in support, upon which we have written to both the Edo and Delta State government on the position of the Redu community with advance copy to Your Majesty. We pray Your Majesty to prevail on the Delta State government and all appropriate authorities to resolve this matter once and for all so as to let the Redu community be. Land challenges to development has no limit. The present settlement of Redu Town is a waterlogged area with marshy ground, which needs some filling, reclamation, and sure embankments. We have written several letters and appeals to government and non-government and intervention agencies, but nothing positive has been done to this end. The case of Redu community is the paradox of a wealthy community living in squalor. After reclamation, water, light for habitable and sustainable living cannot be wished to me. Though we are grateful to Almighty God for giving us a king with passionate heart and vision for the development of the Were Kingdom at this point of our existence. Our expectations are highest of the heaven that the days of our yearning and wandering in the wilderness of our development and frustration will soon be over. Your Majesty, we will be uncharitable to ourselves if we fail to measure the high-heartedness and frustration of MPDC interest on our community over the Kechukwu project, where we are denied the right of ownership and whole status to the project. Instead of the development of our community, we are faced by persecution, divide and rule politics by MPDC first. Your Majesty will look forward to Your Majesty intervention on this matter to enable us get out of this quagmire. Once more, we thank you and God bless. Long live our Emperor Majesty the Lord of Wari. Long live the Were Kingdom. Long live the Redu community. So, yeah.
I'm saying daily. That's the minute. Wasting much time, we'll go into presentation of gifts. If you saw the program I gave to you earlier on, that was supposed to come first. But at times when you have a big visitor, it's good to present your case first before entertainment. That was why I changed the item. Yes, for my boss. We're looking for to make
Thank you. Ba te wa lu ogowe. atuwache oketa no wa ba ji un to ibo pe un presentation biri ebiru reju back in an hello back in the kawoke today show the back in that Eagle Flight Community Bank. I want to call on our beloved mommy, the Olori of Warri Kingdom. Our wonderful mommy that loves us. Agbewagbo Olori. Olori Yanata. That is very significant. Ureju consistently proves itself to be a pioneering community. A community. And so we came up with the idea for you all. In all honesty, we're not even necessarily thinking about Ureju. But God has a way of arranging things. God has a way of setting order. as to who goes first
and the order after that.
I am 100% confident that God's hand is here. And God has a way of revisiting things. I have been having so many inspirations about setting the right foundation so that we can build properly as a kingdom, as a nation, which was why we have sent for Uwedu, so that we could address the injustice that was done to your ancestor. And by the grace of God, we have done that. And I believe that is why God allowed that you would be the first community under this dispensation of the world that we will come and set our feet on. And this gives us an opportunity to address the matter of identity, to address the matter of foundation. Shekiri Nation, without any doubt, we are blessed 100%. But for us to really fully enjoy that blessing that without any doubt God has bestowed upon us as a people and the land we occupy, it is very, very important that the foundations that we are on are just. And oftentimes, because things have been a certain way for centuries, we overlook the fact that there is still something that is not just, even though we have just learned to live on it. And so, I came here dressed with my appropriate shoe gear, knowing what I was going to do. And that's a good thing. And by the grace of God, we will always look good sitting on the throne. But for the mind of our people, it's very important that they know that the king is not just going to sit down in his palace and believe that everything is okay, and believe that his people, who, when you actually look at the numbers, this is easily the wealthiest kingdom in this country. Every inch of this kingdom, if I am not mistaken, is covered by OML, not OPL. They are not prospecting for oil. They are mining for oil. The entirety of this kingdom has producing wells. And so, no inch of this kingdom really should be looking like this. That is just simply the truth. So, it comes down to a matter of the foundation of equity. How are things designated? How are things distributed? And once we have addressed that, stewardship and accountability of those who have been entrusted with that responsibility to ensure that these places see what God has given to them. And so, all of you have your phones. The relevant, the intervention agencies. You mentioned NPDC, you mentioned Chevron. I know the Sopadec gets Shekiri money and all these places. These people in Abuja, Asaba, Warri, Benin, wherever they are, who think, oh no, they are rich, they are fine. They must see that this king, this is what my kingdom looks like. My kingdom does not look like my palace in Warri. So it is for them to understand that it is not fair. It is not fair that the people single-handedly producing so much live in conditions like this.
Okay.
I am not afraid to enter the mud. I will enter the mud and identify that this is my community. And so, once this speech is done and we have left here, we will proceed to the mud. I was told your Ikimi trees, which I was excited to see, are not here. They are downriver. But no, now I've told you to clear the creek so that I would have loved to see those Ikimi trees. But nevertheless, this is where. And I will go and pray and redeem this last. That making our peace with the injustice that was done to Erikogbo. And now that we have come here to redeem this land, things shall begin to change.
Amen.
Amen.
The right attention will be drawn here. Positive development will come.
Amen.
And I'm speaking to all of you, the leaders among you, the people among you. I am praying for good hearts for you, for good mindsets for you. Because once we open this door and the blessings start to show up, do not allow ego, do not allow greed, do not allow pride or any sense of sense entitlement, any spirit to come and say, "Na me go be the big man here." The only big man in this community is Ogiame. And the right thing is done here, so that I hear the correct report where I am. By the grace of God, we will be coming around from time to time. We've done this fanfare. I know when you hear Ogiame is coming, everybody wants to decorate and all that. But we have done this now. We will come quietly to look and see for ourselves. Every blade of grass, every grain of sand, every ounce of mud, every drop of water in this kingdom, God has given me the responsibility to ensure that it is rightfully administered. And by the grace of Almighty God, we'll see that it is so.
Amen.
You are blessed.
Amen.
Every single one of you, you are blessed.
Amen.
Those are far.
Inshallah. Ogami. Ogami.
Ṣé ṣe pàpọ̀ máa ń wọ́n sàgbọ́n àtúwálẹ̀ ọ̀pẹ́ mú ìyẹn wá ṣe tẹ̀rẹ́ ọ̀rí ọkọ̀ mú mẹ́rin.